chick a man be ballin'. These chicks pigeon toed, some of them be crawling.
Spark FM.
Oh gosh, it's me again.
New England's number one urban Caribbean music.
Radio.
Radio.
Spark FM.
Yep.
This is a special intro. You ready?
I like, yeah.
Hold on. Here we go.
Express yourself. Show me what you got, girl. Express yourself. Show me what you got, girl. Express yourself. Show me what you got, girl. Give me. Give me the wine. Express yourself. Show me what you got, girl. Express yourself. Show me what you got, girl. Express yourself. Show me what you got, girl.
Let me do a quick impromptu interview with you, Tristan. When you are figuring out these mixes, how do you figure it out? Like, this could... I can put this in here.
This is effective.
Yeah, effective. How do you do this? Like, how do you figure... Like, this is not two songs that I would have ever managed in together.
Well, you gotta think about it. This is one of the Madonna songs.
Yeah.
So, you know, she's big in the Express Yourself. She's big in the Express Yourself community.
So
you throw that behind
yourself. I see what you did there. Okay, all right then. Good morning, everybody, here on Spark FM Online, Saucy and Friends in the Morning. We are very sorry that we could not be here yesterday for you guys. But it is school vacation. Life be lifing. Miss Tony was man down. Tristan was at a funeral. Had to put a man down.
Yes, I got my what do you call it? My
Wow.
But it was more decked up.
Let me see.
It was more decked up than this that I had to strip it out.
Oh wow, look at that. that's nice. Little picture frame.
Not the best picture, but
yeah. That's so nice.
Rest in peace to Uncle Van, aka Van Martin. He passed away over the weekend, and yesterday we sent him to rest.
Yes, sent him home.
Yeah, man.
Come home. Yeah, so that's what happened. We just wasn't there. So let's start with a quick check-in, see how everybody's doing. Miss Tony, how you feeling, honey?
I'm feeling a little better. I feel like I have more energy. I'm still a little, you know, very congested. Very, very congested. So I think it's like a cold plus allergies that I'm experiencing.
Sure, mm-hmm.
But I'm energetic, which is good. That's a high poppy, which is good. And so, you know, I'm ready for the weekend. I'm ready for tomorrow's the big 420. Sunday is the big roll bounce. I ordered my outfit.
You did?
Wait for that to get here. I can't wait to put that on.
I'm gonna have to go find something to wear today because I don't know what's going on.
Go to the place. They used to have the place in on Mass Ave.
In Cambridge. Garment District.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
I'm gonna have to go there and find something because listen, it's not in my cart.
I forgot to put the order in time today.
Oh, fuck.
Use hand sanitizer.
Oh, that works.
Yeah.
It kills the bacteria.
It kills the stinky bacteria under your arm.
I don't stink. I'm just sweating though.
If y'all ever hear me stink, come on now.
I mean, I'm not gonna lie to you. I could get a little putrid when I don't got no deodorant on.
Putrid.
So I'm look, I got some Lumi. You want some Lumi to put in your armpits?
What's that?
What's Lumi?
Lumi is the deodorant.
I'll be home in a couple of hours.
This one smells good too. Do you use this in your?
What's that? Lotion deodorant?
Cream deodorant.
Really? You just
smell it though.
Let me see.
And I have the Lumi body wash. Ooh, it's so nice.
Oh, this smells wonderful. That don't smell like a deodorant.
This is the one that they say you're supposed to put in your butt. Make your butt don't stink. You can use it in your belly button too.
Oh wow. That is innovative. Innovative, that is what they call it.
You use it like in all the parts that sweat that might get a little, you know, whatever. So like even you've got a big butt, right? So like right in the crease of your butt. Because it gets sweaty and all of that. And so it takes away this sweat and it takes away odor. Lumi.
Oh wow.
Good stuff.
I could put that betwixt my legs when I'm walking.
Yep.
Like a little deodorant.
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice.
It's nice.
Okay,
I like it.
Okay. Get a little Lumi.
Yeah.
And
how are you doing?
How was your eat? What did you do? Did you do anything?
Oh, we had family dinner last night to celebrate the 35th anniversary of our aunt and uncle. So that was really, really nice. We had some nice barbecue ribs and some fried rice and some salad.
Wow.
35 years.
That's a blessing.
Yes, and they are still having fun together and still like each other.
They're the funnest couple because they be traveling they and going do. To parties and events. I like to see old West Indian couples, not old, but you know, like the older generation West Indian couples still out in the club having a good time.
Yeah.
What's my girl name?
Cummins.
Yes, Cheryl Cummins.
Oh, yes, and her husband.
Cheryl Cummins and her husband, they be out all the time, and I admire seeing them out.
I love that.
You know, nice.
Yeah.
I love that. I mean, you know, Auntie Brenda and Uncle Corbin, one of my favorite people, couples, and they have a good time. We have all the time together. Like, that's his girl. That's her boy, and they have a good time together, and I like that. That's an inspiration for me.
Have y'all ever thought about... Have y'all ever thought that you were born in the wrong era?
Yes.
Well,
and if so, what era do you think I should have born?
Like this era.
Not this one?
This one.
I should have been born like the 50s when everybody had suits.
Dressed up and looked nice. No,
nice.
You know what? Like, I don't think so. I think that I was born at the time that I was supposed to, because I don't think that there's a lot of things that I could have handled from the 50s era. Like, the whole housewife thing probably wouldn't have worked for me.
And then this era now,
with whatever the foolishness is.
This foolishness is
loose. Looseness that's going on now.
You know
what?
Me think about a whole bunch of other things.
Yeah, I couldn't deal. So I think that I came at the right time. I couldn't deal with the 60s and whatever black people went through then.
Right.
The 70s with all the hippies. The peace and love.
I think I could have done the peace and love with the hippies, be out in the field in Woodstock kissing each other.
I mean, that was the start of when it was good, right? But the 80s was definitely, for me growing up in the 80s was a great, great time. The 90s was amazing. I would live the 90s over and over.
Yeah.
And then, you know, like from there, it's gone on to whatever. I've experienced what I've experienced and had a good time. My life has been good. I've had a good life. Yeah. I can say that. I've gone through some stuff, but I've had some really, really good times as well. So I think I'm right on time.
Okay.
I think God knew what he was doing.
The Lord knows and the Lord will supply.
What about you,
Rockstone Trismas? How was you? How was your evening?
No, it was very somber. It's somber. You know, like I said, I was at a funeral yesterday, and that was it. That was about it. I'm getting ready for the 420 brunch on Saturday, getting ready for Roll Bounce on Sunday. So, yeah, I got a whole lot of work to do between today and tomorrow.
And tomorrow.
Yeah.
How is everything? Are you lined up good?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, my voice. Reworking on it, but today after the show, I pick up my niece. I have a whole shout out to my peoples. I got a whole group of people that's working with me this year. I am just thankful that they're helping me out, and they ain't getting paid because I ain't getting no money.
I ain't got it.
Listen,
there's a time when you got to tell people I ain't got it.
Yeah, I just need your help.
Yeah.
You need me, holler at me.
Yeah, exactly.
We'll be passing through, of course, per usual.
There's so many things going on tomorrow, 420 wise.
Christ.
Yeah.
Everybody, Yamba Boutique is launching their grand opening tomorrow, too.
I am excited about that.
Yeah,
Yamba Boutique.
It's so pretty.
The 420 block party going down. There's so much different things going on this year.
I know that 420 is a big day, but I wonder if it doesn't have to be so many things. You know,
but it's going to be able to spread out. And then I'm ending my afternoon tomorrow night going to Menden Drive-In, and they're playing Half Baked, and they're also playing Pineapple Express.
Oh, that's going to be awesome.
That's going to be lit.
I remember I laid in the bed between mommy and daddy, and we watched Pineapple Express one Sunday. And that's such a vivid memory for me because
you
it was
and
like,
mommy and they daddy.
Sat there me, and mommy it? And daddy, and we laid in their bed and watched Pineapple Express.
Me too?
Interesting.
I don't think you were there. I don't know where you were, but it was a very interesting thing.
Interesting choice.
Yeah. It was weird.
That didn't have a lot of cussing in it.
It had all kinds of stuff in it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Crazy.
Yeah, man. And you know, we're getting ready for the show.
Yeah.
And Sauce, take it away.
Yes, and I did go to F1 grand opening downtown.
Oh, you went?
I saw that on the news last night too.
Was it?
Yeah.
We got there very, very late. Very like probably like around 8 o'clock. It started at 6. There was a F1 car outside, and it was a lot of people. It's a beautiful place. I think that it's going to be one of those places that people like love to go to. Like the, it's a real, it's like, what is it? 69 racing car stimulators. It's a lot of bar area. There's other games. The food is great. From what I heard from everybody, but it is nice. It is nice. Go over to the Seaport. It is open. They are open till pretty late. They got a full liquor license. You can go in there and ride the cars. They actually shake. So you feel it. They give you directions on how to move through this. So it was very nice. I didn't stay there too long. It's right by, let me tell you, it's right by Shake Shack.
Oh, okay.
So Shake Shack is on this side. Mm-hmm. It's right there. And it's on the second floor. So
like across from?
From across from Lumi. What is that car, that electric car, and you see it in the window right on the corner when you come through Seaport. You know, when we go in that way.
Oh, no.
Seaport taking all the money away.
Is it like, it's across from like Grace by Mia?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Shake Shack is across from where we had Spark the Block last year.
Yeah, right. So you can see where we had Spark the Block from the window. So it's not like, you know, there's four sides. Uh-huh. Shake Shack is on this side and the A1 arcade is on this side.
Okay.
Yeah. It's on that main street. Oh, yeah, wow. So it's dope. I encourage everybody to go check it out. Go, you know, take a listen. I mean, don't go, you know, just go there. It's a good experience, especially if you know somebody who loves racing and things like that. Then it is an absolutely, you know, great experience. So then I came home and then I went to sleep because I be tired. Golly, I'm tired these days, I tell you. Boy, I tell you. But with that said, let's get into the show because we got a lot of grounds to cover. We're going to be talking to Jeff Samillion today, the owner of Low Key Dispensary and a very special person to Spark FM because he helped us find our new location. So we'll talk about real estate. We'll talk about Kings Amongst Kings. We'll talk about Low Key Dispensary. We'll talk about many, many things as we upcome the next interview. We're going to get into Around the Way news right now. Saucy and Friends.
You're listening to Saucy and Friends in the morning with Miss Hot Sauce, Miss Tony, and Rockstone Triz.
Call Spark FM at 617-272-3387. Advertise your business, brand, or music on Spark FM. Contact us at sparkfmonline.com for more information.
The all-new Spark FM. Spark FM. Log on to sparkfmonline.com.
Tristan, I just sent you the thingy. Good morning, everybody. We are here. It's time for us to get into our Around the Way news. Let's find out what's going on in here. Like since we're just right off the topic, first F1 arcade in the United States opening in Boston Seaport. It did open last night. There's only two other ones, one in London and one in somewhere else in Europe. And then this was the first American arcade, so it is modeled just like the other two. So there are complete replicas, like there's two other replicas, but this is the first one in Boston. They do have plans to put more around the place, but it is going to be a great situation. I'm going to post some pictures from it so you guys can look at it, or just go into the Spark FM take a look at it.
Where you send me? Where you send it?
Here on your cellular phone to post on Instagram.
Oh, okay, thank you.
Yes. So that opened up yesterday. Boston-bound JetBlue flight has close call on runway at Reagan International Airport, which I don't understand. It seems to me that these days, the planes are coming in such close proximity to each other and or breaking up.
Listen.
What are we supposed to do with this information?
I was watching the planes come in the other night. And they, you know, if you go to like the right spot in Boston, you can watch them kind of like lined up when they're coming in. And sometimes it'd be two planes looking like they coming in at the same time or something like that. Mm. So I'm like, what's going on with the air traffic control? Mm-hmm. Oh, I like it purple.
Thank you. You said purple.
Yeah. I'm like, what's going on with the air traffic control that they're not doing that right? It looks unsafe to me. So hearing about all these plane accidents isn't really...
It seems like they're dropping the ball in the in the airplane.
Yeah, like they're just really not paying attention. Like somebody is in there, is working from home, and when they should be traffic controlling the traffic, they are taking a shower or going to Marshall's. Like, and I feel like you should sit. I feel like that job, you should be at home. You should be at the place.
Did you watch the show with Idris Elba?
Not yet. What's it called again? Stranger Things. Here's the clip.
Today in aviation, where we're not talking about a catastrophe.
The planes were just seconds from disaster. A JetBlue flight gaining speed and taking off for Boston just as a Southwest plane was cleared to cross in front of it. You can hear the panic as air traffic controllers yell at the pilots to stop.
Stop.
We were on the runway taking flight and then they hit the brakes.
This woman was on that flight to Boston as the plane aborted its takeoff, delayed for hours because of the near miss at Washington's Reagan National Airport.
We were rerouted back to the gate where they did their checks.
In my opinion, this was a very serious situation because there was almost no margin for any further error.
The planes did not hit, but they came dangerously close, just 400 feet apart, according to Flight Radar 24 data.
The 737 is around 150 feet long, so 400 feet is about three airplane lengths. That's not enough.
Today's close call is one of several near misses in the last year, and that has prompted the FAA to review procedures at airports across the country.
You get these second chances. But ultimately, second chances can only take you so far before, as they say, the worst of the worst happens.
And the FAA tonight is investigating what happened. The airlines say that they will be working with federal investigators.
I just feel like we're reading too much of these stories.
Yeah. It's like I said, it's the air traffic control that is in charge of these things. Like, I don't know how well the visibility is. I mean, I know that for the people, but like they only do what they're being directed to do, right? I asked about that movie because the air traffic control people in that movie were like on point. But
they knew what to do.
They knew what to do and they was very on point. Like they knew the centimeters and all of that stuff. But these people who are doing this these days that we'll be reading about, it just seems like they're not paying attention the way that they need to. And isn't there like AI for that now? Isn't it computerized or something? Like what's going on?
And I'm glad that you bring that up. Because these days, technology is so much better that you should be more accurate towards things. And I'm just not understanding why it seems like the planes in general are regressing.
Yeah.
I don't get it.
Yeah, me either.
A Dorchester condo owner is standing up to thieves who stole six packages off the porch of her building in broad daylight. The alleged theft happened outside a resident on Dick Street around 5 p.m. on Wednesday. The victim, Allie Burchill, says at least six packages were stolen by two masked men. The men didn't have their faces covered until one of them walked up onto the porch. Surveillance video from the front porch of the apartment shows two men scanning the area before making off with multiple boxes. One of the suspects is seen wheeling a shopping cart full of items.
Not a shopping cart. Wow.
Where did they came from?
Ah! Exactly.
Ridiculous.
South Bay Target.
Amongst other things, Burchill says a pair of shoes she ordered for her one-year-old son was stolen. That's just rude. I'm just hoping more people start reporting it, she says. I feel like most people think they're invincible and that they can take people's stuff and nobody's going to do anything about it. Burchill says she reached out to Boston police and plans to file a report with them on Friday. In the meantime, she's considering having her packages delivered elsewhere until she figures out a better solution to stop it from happening. Can't you talk to the people from the Ring cameras? Like, hey, put that down. Put it down.
Yeah.
Drop it. I'm calling the police.
Yeah,
I'm
you don't even have to be home to do that.
Oh, but unless you see them.
She's not seeing it?
On our walks in the evening, we pass by this house, and as soon as you get on the grass, there's a voice that starts saying, hello, and something, something, something. I never stop to listen to it because I think that's creepy. But in this situation, I think that once you have a sensor somewhere and it catches, look at him taking the boxes. That's crazy. Go to this story because I want to watch.
Long time.
Mark, there are visible signs posted here on this property that surveillance cameras are rolling. That didn't seem to stop two thieves from lurking out front for several minutes before one of them snagged all of the packages off of this front porch.
Not one, all.
Very clear that they were just like very nonchalant about it.
Surveillance footage captures two thieves on an early evening stroll down Dick Street in the Fields Corner section of Dorchester on Wednesday. One of them wheeling a shopping cart full of items.
That guy's dumb, doesn't have a mask on.
Neither had their faces covered until one walked up onto the porch looking down at an area where six packages had been dropped off.
They just truly do not care, steal anything that they can grab.
One of the packages belonged to Allie Burchill. Inside were the Nike shoes she had ordered for her one-year-old son.
I'm sure they thought it was going to be something much better than baby shoes.
She can be heard giving a play-by-play narration in the video she sent to us.
It
shows the suspect initially leaving the porch empty-handed.
Now he puts his mask on. I can't with these two.
Moments later, he returns, leans down, and walks away with the stolen packages stacked up in his arms.
Most people just feel like they're invincible and they can take people's stuff and no one's going to do anything about it.
But she has had enough. She shared this surveillance video showing a suspect with a similar MO entering her porch in March of last year, stealing packages belonging to her and fellow condo owners in her building.
I think everyone's just sick of this happening on our street.
The signs that have since been posted notifying visitors that cameras are watching did not deter a repeat encounter. So this time, she's hoping police can do something about it.
You can't trust getting stuff sent to your house. You can't trust people in your neighborhood.
Burchill says
that's
she's
very bold-faced.
It's brazen.
It is like you sat down and you took your trash bag and you took all these people's stuff. That's got that is.
But she, when she was like, I can't with these people. You are show your face. Walk come off the door. Porch. Put on your mask and come back. We see you.
I'm someone else. I'm not the same person.
Wow. That's so crazy. This is how I feel. They leave the packages outside of our door all the time.
Yeah.
And we've had to like literally, I saw the girl, my next door neighbor, put a sign that was like, ring any doorbell so somebody can open the door and just leave the package inside. Do not leave it outside. On Blue Hill Ave. Like, what is wrong with you? Nobody's been stealing our pack. Well,
but
I did get
that's the thing, though. Like, I feel like she said that they live in a condo.
Yeah.
Isn't there a common area that...
There has to be,
that the delivery people can have to get in? Like you said, ring any doorbell instead of leave... There's 47 packages outside those people's house.
Yep.
Yeah. There was one side, and if you look to the end of the video...
I was wondering if he was going to come back for the other packages
too.
On the other side.
Like, that's way too much package. If I was a thief, I'm stopping there every time.
Seriously.
That's where I'm going. Yeah. These people get good stuff. Yeah. They probably reordered what I already stole, and I like it.
Yep.
I need baby shoes, too. Them men's look like they have lots of kids.
Ew. Imagine that. Imagine your baby daddy being a porch pirate.
I would be mad about it. Let's get Boston-based Wayfair announces opening date for first large format store. What the hell is a large format store?
I know. Is that like an IKEA?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
A Wayfair?
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Wow.
That's gonna be great. Their inaugural Wayfair spanning 150,000. Damn, that's a lot of thousands of feet. 150,000 square feet. We'll be welcoming customers in Wilmette, Illinois on May 23rd.
Boston?
Oh. Well, they're not opening here, so we don't care.
Hmm. Where is it going to be?
In Wilmette, Illinois.
Okay. All right.
Well, yeah, story was misplaced.
We don't have to we don't have nothing to do with that.
That's interesting. Why wouldn't they open one here?
Exactly. It's not like we don't have the space. Take it to hell downtown. They looking for people to occupy space downtown. Seriously. Open a big ass Wayfair downtown and let people go down there to go to Wayfair. I mean, duh.
Yeah.
Friggin' duh.
Yeah.
Bus and police warn fans of counterfeit Celtics and Bruins tickets ahead of playoff push-off. With both the Celtics and Bruins gearing up for playoff pushes this weekend at the TD Garden, Boston police are warning the public about fake ticket scams. Officials are encouraging fans to buy tickets from authorized ticket agencies and to be wary if a deal seems too good to be true. Fans who purchase tickets from a secondary source are taking a chance to do so at the buyer's own risk. Purchasing tickets via other means creates the potential for possessing an invalid and or counterfeit ticket. Ryan White flew into Boston Thursday with his Celtics first round playoff tickets ready in tow. The Tampa native used Ticketmaster to purchase his seat to Sunday's game. He didn't want to mess around and buy his ticket from an unreliable source, especially being from out of town. This story is not pleasing me, Ryan. It's not it was no climax to that.
Exactly.
He didn't want to get scammed. So, of course, he would buy it from Ticketmaster. If you're out of town, how else would you know?
Those $50,000 million of fees.
Which I thought Biden was putting the stop to, did he?
No.
Not yet.
Ticketmaster charges you a whole ticket worth
of fees.
Yep.
Avoid buying, here are some precautions. Avoid buying from individuals you don't know. Buy your tickets with a credit card so you can do a little charge back if there needs to. Make sure the seats exist in the actual venue. That is a big one.
Mm.
Go and look and see if your seat's used.
Yeah.
They say people can use Photoshop to make these amazing looking counterfeits, and they'll put in random rows and seats that don't even exist. That's crazy.
That's
beware of verification scams. Watch out for anyone selling tickets who wants you to send a code to verify your identity. That's usually a scam to create a Google Voice account in your name.
Oh, really?
Interesting. But these are all the precautions that you should take when buying Celtics tickets. Big shout out to DJ Y-Sham. I saw that someone gifted her a pair of tickets to go to the playoffs, and she's really excited. And she deserves it. And then let's see what else we have here. Vultures believed to be seriously ill. Instead, were just literally too drunk to fly.
Yeah.
The vultures was getting drunk?
Yeah.
Why? Two vultures feared to be critically ill were instead literally too drunk to fly. After getting into something in a grocery store dumpster, wildlife rescuers in Connecticut said in a social media post, the pair found on April 7th in Watertown were quickly released back into the wild after spending a night recovering from a wicked hangover. A place called Hope said in the post, an animal control officer in Watertown found one of the birds near a meat market's garbage container and thought it might have been hit by a car. The second bird was found soon after in the same location and brought to Cummings Raptor Rehabilitation Center. Cummings said that when the birds were found, the duo had trouble balancing and would pass out. After some testing and observation, rescuers said they believed the birds came upon something in the dumpster that was fermented enough to get them drunk. While they could not be sure of what the birds got into, a place called Hope said cocktail drinkers should be mindful that fruit used in cocktails and then thrown away could be eaten by hungry wildlife and cause intoxication. I mean, what that got to do with me? I threw it away. They didn't have to go in the trash and take what I put through away. Now
you
your drunk ass can't fly.
Tipping over and all kind of things. That
I didn't know we had vultures.
Me either.
Yes.
And that scares me.
That's it.
Because it's funny because they always say be careful with little dogs. With little tiny dogs. Girl, pulling one of them little teacup poodles. And that thing pulled so much that it was tilted the other way. She was walking tilted because she was pulling. And the owner just didn't pay it no mind. She was just walking casually. And that thing was just,
That's the little dog that I had. I was like, that was when the coyotes was out in here in Hyde Park.
No, hell no.
And I was like, I'm not walking that because if a coyote approached me, I'm just letting it loose. I'm not fighting no coyote for this dog. So, you know, that was another reason the dog had
to go. Was
that
a mini one?
It was just the smallest. It was like a. It looked like a rabbit and the chihuahua mix. Because remember, it had them big old long ears. I don't know what that was, but I was like, I'm not.
You had it for a week.
Oh, it was a week.
A whole week.
Yep.
What were you doing with it for that
suffering.
Week?
Suffering.
Were you walking all the time?
Nope.
And
nope.
Chris said now they're gonna ban fruits in the drink.
To save the damn dogs. That's crazy.
Listen.
Ooh, I tell you, that is crazy.
Dogs have more rights than we do.
They sure do.
So.
They sure do. You cannot kick a dog.
Yep.
You can kick a person, though.
Yep.
It's crazy.
Yep.
Anyhow,
no, because if you kick a person, then that's shod foot. Remember?
Oh yeah, shod foot. There was a truck, and a truck ends up on top of cars after a crash in Brockton. A developing story as well to find out what happened. But other than that, that's all we have for the Around the Way news. Mm-hmm. Whatever else is news is Roll Bounce on Sunday for adult skate night at Shea Vu's. We are teaming up with Shea Vu's over there, right over there on Blue Hill Ave, and we will be there from 8 to 12. The bar will be open. Food mm-hmm. will be served. People will be skating. And Road music Street. Will be... Yes, that is it.
Yes.
And people will be dancing.
Yes.
Even if you don't skate, come in, take a few pictures, take them off, you know. Do what
you
it is.
You can roll or you can bounce.
Exactly.
Roll.
I like what you did there.
Hey, shout out to Boston Project Rebound Reentry Services in the house.
Oh, Steven, that was my friend from Walmart the other day.
Steven!
Hi, Steven. Yes, they have a really great program called Boston Project Rebound Reentry Services in the house. Yes, they are in the house. They help people get back, you know, people that have come from the jailhouse. They help them get their lives together so that there's no reentry and that they can, recidivism.
That's
what I like, a good recidivism.
I'm telling you, you meet good people in the Walmart.
They do. Mm-hmm. I forgot your roommate's name, and they have also a podcast and a TV show that they do, and they talk about many different things and many different people in the city of Boston. So make sure you guys go check them out. Steven, thank you for joining us. That's so exciting.
Tell a friend, share the Mike. Live. Tell a friend,
His friend's name is Mike.
Mike, yes, Mike.
You got Mike.
Shout out to Mike and the cat. With that said, we're going to go to a quick commercial break. And when we come back, we'll be talking to Jeff Simillion from Low Key Dispensary and Thumbprint Realty and Kings Amongst Kings. Keep it locked right here, Spark FM Online.
What is this, Doctor?
This is
Spark of New England, Spark FM.
Bringing the heat back to the airwaves.
Turn us up.
All right,
let's take a look.
Spark FM invites you to roll bounce.
Sunday, April 21st.
Dust off those bell bottoms, baggy jeans, leg warmers, and let's shake, skate, and sparkle.
Ladies and gentlemen, Spark FM is turning full.
Our 4th anniversary celebration, let's boogie on down the rink, throwback style. This all goes down Sunday, April 21st from 8 to 12 a.m. Roll, bounce, and rep your favorite 80s, 90s, and 2000s era.
Music provided by Spark FM DJs.
Shea Boo's resident DJ, Manny Reese.
Cost of is $15 with skate and $20 without. Get your tickets at sparkfmrollbounce.eventbrite.com.
It's 12 past midnight. Don't close your eyes. Your soul's up for life.
Massachusetts Social Equity Program creates pathways into the cannabis industry for those most harmed by the war on drugs. The Cannabis Control Commission offers free education and tools to navigate the legal marketplace, including focused training and support on entrepreneurship, management, entry-level employment, and ancillary vendor support. To apply, visit masscannabiscontrol.com/equity. That's masscannabiscontrol.com/equity.
Did you know that you can now get a standard Massachusetts driver's license regardless of your immigration status? To get help with your application, a list of all required documents, and nearby appointment scheduling, visit mass.gov/WFMA. Your license is your way forward, so why not get started today? Register now at mass.gov/WFMA or call 857-368-WFMA.
Hello. I'm Marissa Jarrett Winoker. Performing on stage takes mental and physical preparation. But one thing I never thought to prepare for was cervical cancer. 91% of cervical cancers are caused by the human papillomavirus, or HPV. One in every four Americans is infected with HPV. For many people, the virus hides inside them and they never develop symptoms. But for others, HPV links directly to cancer. My cancer almost ended my career. It almost ended me. The good news is there are vaccines that can protect you or your children from cancer. The HPV vaccine is recommended for children 11 to 12 years old and a catch-up vaccine may be an option for teens and young adults. Talk to your doctor. You don't want HPV hiding inside of you. Go to thinkaboutthelink.org to learn more. Together, we can stop cancer before it starts.
Spark FM.
I know you nasty. She be touching on her own body.
Igniting the airwaves. Spark FM.
Says she wanna take me away. Says she wanna take me away. Says she wanna show me the way.
Join us on Facebook and Instagram at SparkFMOnline.com. Turn us up. Spark FM.
Spark FM Online, number one for urban and Caribbean music. We are back. We are back. And like we said, on Fridays, we have a little bit of fun. So today we brought in some fun people. Well, we brought in a fun person who would like to tell us about his fun things. Caller, you're live.
Hey, this is Boston Project Rebound in the house.
Hey, Steven, how are you?
Good. Hey, thanks for the shout out, guys.
No problem. I'm glad that you called us, and I'm glad that you tuned in.
Yeah, we're enjoying it so far.
All right, awesome. You guys keep it, hang tight. We're going to get through this interview, and we'll talk to you guys a little bit later.
Hey, if you never need us to do an interview, we're happy to do an interview with you guys.
Definitely, we'll touch base with you.
Hey, just to let you know, our touring blog is called touringnewengland.org. We go around New England and do stories on different tours, attractions, events, and all types of really cool things about New England. Touring, something like very like Chronicle.
Touringnewengland.com.
.org.
.org. Okay, gotcha. We'll check it out right after this. Thank you, Steven. Bye.
Bye-bye, everybody. Thanks for calling.
Bye. I love Steven and Mike. They're my favorites. We met Steven and Mike in Walmart and had a long conversation with them about content creation and so many other things. And I'm glad that we're going to chop this up with Jeff Samillion right now. Good morning, Jeff. How you doing?
Good morning.
Oh, let me put you up so the people can hear you. Now they can hear you.
Good morning. Happy to be here.
Happy to have you here. This is so exciting. Last time we talked to you was about a year ago.
I know.
And you came in for Money Matters Monday with Chase Bank. But this time, we have a lot to talk about and a lot to celebrate because it's all about you.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
So congratulations on the opening of Low Key. How long have you guys been open now?
We've been open since October 8th. We've been open since October 8th, so that's going on about 6 months now. Yeah. Oh, well over 6 months since then. So it's been a great half a year now so far.
How's it been? Like, how's business? Is it what you thought it was going to be when you?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. But there's that saying: there's your plans and then there's God's plan.
Yeah.
Right. So that's really really. The mantra and how I'm living life these days is just like there's my plans and whatever God got for me and welcome in.
with the grand opening, you have been able to make a lot of great partnerships. But before we get into that, what other things do you have going on? We mentioned a few of them, but can you tell us a little bit more about Kings Amongst Kings?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah, Kings Amongst Kings. Kings Amongst Kings is basically a nonprofit that I started. That saying, be the change you want to see in the world, right? I've had a lot of people pouring to me. So my goal is to be able to pour into others as well or utilize my resources and my network and provide other black and brown men the same opportunities and same resources, same connections.
What do you guys do there?
What do we do? We do a lot. The whole goal is to really just change the narrative, right, of what black men is and what black men does and what black men is supposed to look like, what we're supposed to talk about, how we're supposed to feel, so on and so forth. We have conversation about how to become better fathers, become better husband, become better individual, better businessmen, right? How to create legacy for us, for our families. How do we speak better to our women, to our wives? How to level up, mentally, physically, emotionally, you know, how to better ourselves. You know what I mean? Mental health. We've had therapists come into our space to speak to us about, you know, trauma that we had growing up, and then how do we, you know, let that go and let that, you know, bad trauma go and move forward.
I think that's, it sounds like it's really important. We often think about, you know, what resources are available to Black men outside. Yesterday, I also attended a screening for a documentary about living on the streets of Boston and different, you know, like different, it was the, not serve safe. I just left the paper at home. But anyways, it was a documentary about, you know, the stigmatisms, the hardship, the PTSD that a lot of Black men go through while being raised in urban societies and communities, and how a lot of these people that are, you know, quote unquote career criminals, how they have to deal with things. So I think it's amazing that you have an organization that gives fellowship to Black men. Yes. To help them to stay on the right path.
100%. 100%. Yeah. I mean, you don't necessarily have to be a Black man that wants to be in business to be part of Kings Amongst Kings. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It's just how to become a better person overall.
Yeah.
That's really your focus. You know what I mean? How do you add value, contribute to society, to your community, to your family.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And just being a better person overall.
And
you know?
You're a good example of that, because not only are you a serial entrepreneur, but you are also a dad of two beautiful babies. You are a husband. How does this all work? Like, how do you have time to do anything?
actually, I don't. Sometimes I'm like, man, how is all these things getting done? And one of the things that I just realize is just the consistency level that I've put in all the things that I've done.
Yeah.
I have this faith, consistency, and hard work, right? Mm-hmm. So the hard work is the everyday grind we all do, we all put in. Mm-hmm. But a lot of times some of us are not consistent with the hard work, right? So we work hard, you know, for two weeks, 2 days, 2 months, 2 years, wow. And we don't get the result, and then we quit.
Wow, call me out.
You know, but at the end of the day, like I said, it takes time for you to get the result, to see the vision, right? So you have to be consistent, and you got to have faith.
Yeah.
Right? So that's really what it takes, is faith, consistency, and hard work. So a lot of us does the work, but what we don't have is the faith. What we don't have is the consistency, you know what I mean, to let the work, you know, come to fruition. So, you know what I mean? That's really what separates a lot of us. You know what I mean? So it's just really just teaching that.
I think that's so true. Like, there's a lot of people that have good ideas, good talent, good vision.
Good vision.
But the consistency is not there.
Consistency, mentorship, the guidance. You know what I mean? And that's what really separates a lot of people, right? And a lot of people are talented. We are talented based, but, you know, it's easy to start a business, but it's hard to maintain a business. Oh, it's like having a child. You know what I mean? It's easy to make them, but raising them and being consistent and you know, raising a productive child, a productive, you know, human being, is it's sort of like creating a successful $1 million business. You know what I mean? A unicorn, right? So it takes time and it takes hard work. So.
And then let's switch gears into Thumbprint Realty. Not only are you a dispensary owner, we'll get back to that a little bit later. You are the founder and the president of Kings Amongst Kings, but you are also a real estate agent as well.
Yes. Well, that's sort of what got me into all of to all this, you know what I mean?
Being
in real estate. Real estate opened the doors for me. You know, I started off doing rentals in Austin, Brighton, you know, over a decade ago.
In the nice neighborhood.
Yeah. I mean, I grew up in Dorchester, so I was doing rentals here, but but the challenge that I had at that time, you know, a lot of people get into real estate, right, with the wrong mindset. So when I got into real estate, it was because I wanted to make money.
Yeah.
Right.
I was thinking about getting into real estate the other day. Yeah. I was like, I can sell a few houses.
Yeah. Well, that's the challenge. That's what I mean. So selling a house or two, that doesn't necessarily mean you're going to make money. Mm-hmm. Right? Okay. You know, because, so anybody, you could help anybody buy a house, right? Yeah. And again, this is where the consistency comes in. So, right, you have to do it over and over and over. It takes you anywhere. It could take you three months, 6 months, a year
to make a sale. sell.
To make a sale, absolutely.
Oh, see,
so there's no money there.
The real estate game got me messed up because I was like, I'm going to get in, I'm going to sell a house immediately, I'm rich.
Nah, it doesn't work that way. So that's you have to be intentional. So that's what happened. A lot of agents, a lot of people go into it thinking that they're going to make money and they're not intentional. So you have to be intentional to say, okay, I want to make this amount of money. Mm-hmm. And this is what I need to do, and you have to close 3 deals a month, you know, 6 deals in you know, every quarter, or whatever it is, whatever your goal is. So a lot of people don't go into that mindset, and then if you know, few months into it, then they realize, like, oh, this ain't it. I'm just going to go back to my old job, and that's when the consistency is not there. So for me, when I came in rentals, and I was doing rentals.
How old were you when you came in?
Rentals, I was 27.
Okay.
Yeah, so I was chasing, you know, not chasing, but it was a lot of hustling, right?
Yeah.
So my, then I got to realize that, okay, I could hustle, right? But there's no loyalty in rentals because.
I was about to say, yeah, if I'm looking for an apartment, if you tell me I got one, bye.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So there's no loyalty. So when that made me realize, oh, yeah, the longevity, the consistency there, it's not really there for me to really create a long long term career. Then residential sales, like you just said, selling house, right? You go into that, it could take you 6 months, you know, 9 months or whatever it is, depending.
Especially with the market being.
Especially with the market it is now. But there's always a challenge in the market, right? So whoever it is, it might be your buyer may not be qualified, it might be FHA client, it might be a knocker client. So there's a lot of different programs that they might be using, which makes it a little bit more challenging, a little bit more tougher process.
Why do the programs make it a tougher process?
It's just checking balances, you know what I mean? You got to go through the ladder, you got to make
different
sure every, you know what I'm saying, different organizations, there's so many different people involved, right? So it, not only you the buyer, right, then you got to have a lender that you have to have a underwriter, right? Okay. Appraiser. So there's so many different moving pieces it comes to.
Is this a good housing market? I don't know if you're going to say that because, you know, it depends.
Like, is it a good housing market for who? For a buyer or a seller?
For a seller, probably it's a good market.
Yeah, it's a good market for a seller. I mean, it could be a good market for a buyer if you could afford it. I mean, one of my agents, at Thumbprint, told me a couple of days ago she's working with a buyer, a friend of mine that I know, and I was just asking her, how is it going. She just told me that they submitted an offer in Rhode Island, right? Rhode Island.
Oh, Rhode Island.
Yes, and somebody else offered $100,000 over.
Oh, wow.
For two family.
$100,000 over?
Over in Rhode Island for two family.
Oh, man.
So
why would you do that?
Because they
wanted the house.
Like what you just said. You just asked. It's a good market. I mean, this is what's going on in the market these days. I mean, people are buying up everything.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So if you could afford it, if you could afford an extra $100,000, then, you know, you buy it now. And look at Boston. Like, you know, 10 years ago, the same property that's selling for 1.5, 1.6, 1.7 was, you know, 900,000. It was 800,000. It was 700,000. So, you know what I mean? So this is what 10 years make. So, you know,
But now you're into, are you into commercial now?
Yes, yes. So, you know, going in, making the transition and figuring out, okay, where's my long-term longevity? Commercial really was what was better suited for me.
And big shout out to you on your commercial, your commercial ass talent.
Yeah.
I don't even know what to say. I was just excited. I just wanted to say Jeff played a pivotal role in getting Spark FM its new location. I had asked him about something else, and he was like, "But what about this?" And I said, "Got him."
Oh, that's what you did? I said got her.
I was like, shoot, I didn't even know that was on the market.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Well, so that's what I wanted to go into with commercial real estate. There's more creativity, and it's a longer process. The deals could take longer as well, but there's more creativity there, and then there's more control and less bureaucracy, less paperwork. It's more so, can you afford the place?
Yeah.
And can we get you to be able to afford it? You know, there's grants, there's, you know what I mean, all these different funding access out there that we could help a business owner, especially in the city of Boston now with space grant, with all these.
There's another round coming out, so y'all gotta snatch them
off. Yeah, people need to try to stop tapping the thumbprint. You know, we got a lot of listings. So if you're looking for a commercial space, you know, we don't want to reach out to, so we can help you out, as you just said, right?
I mean, I see your name on some big buildings, that liquor store down there on River Street.
Yeah, we leased that out already.
Oh, did you?
That building that's coming up in Four Corners.
Yeah, Four Corners. Yeah, we got some spaces there as well.
Four Corners.
What? We're about to put a restaurant there, and then we need something else.
That's a sit-down restaurant?
Sit-down restaurant with a liquor license, you know,
yes!
Everything.
Yes.
Wow. We're changing the neighborhood. I grew up right on Claiborne Street, which is, like, directly in front of that building. So I'm happy that I was able to
facilitate that and really create that.
What's going on with the liquor store in Mattapan? Can you tell us anything on that?
There's nothing. I mean, they just they switched.
Is it
going to stay a liquor store?
Well, no, it's the liquor store just literally moved right next door, and you know, so they were on Edgewater, but now they're on River Street, which is like right on the side, So they're still there. They didn't move any further.
You need a nice little restaurant, black owned, right there.
In Mattapan,
where that liquor store used to be.
Unfortunately, can't happen there.
Yeah, Edgewater has that little reputation. Yeah.
Going back to dispense, to the low key dispensary, you've got some pretty name, heavy name brands. You had a great party last night.
I thought you was coming.
Listen, I had to be in three places at the same time. It was ridiculous.
I was at three places at once last night.
Too. I saw that. I was in your stories this morning. I was like, "What the hell is he now?" But tell us about you. You have partnered with Method Man.
Yes. Yeah.
Tikal.
Shout out to Tikal. Shout out to Meth. Shout out to the whole team Z.
When he coming in?
Well, you know, the more we can sell the product, you know what I mean. Then he has a reason to come here.
He got a reason to come here right now. Tell him you need to talk to him in person real quick. Then invite me, and then we'll have a conversation.
I'll let you know when I let you know who's coming here. You know, give him a shout out. Call him. Tell him you want to interview him on Spark
FM.
That's not all
I want to do, Jeff. Okay. No, but how is that going? Not only have you partnered with that, but you have your own strain of locally grown branded
product to continue on Tikal. So yeah, that's that's a relationship that came about a couple of years ago when I was doing my due diligence, my research, and understanding the cannabis space, where you know, where the industry was going to as far as branding wise. And when we went out to Colorado, we was out in Denver, and it was hard to find that product. Not saying hard, but it was in special locations. You know what I mean? So we had to go to a particular store. So when I ended up purchasing it, so we just, you know, sent them a DM. I sent the whole team DM, like, you know, just like if I were to say, "Hey, Spark FM, I want to be on the show."
Yeah.
So I did the same thing, you know, sent them a DM, say, "Hey, we're opening up a dispensary in Boston. We'd love to have them in Boston here." So they replied, and you know, we went back and forth
on
the DM.
That's dope.
Went back and forth on the email, signed an NDA, and, you know, sort of had a conversation and made sure that, you know, our goals lined up and this, you know, our values goals lined up. So we were able to create, you know, a partnership.
Do you have any more of those kind of celebrity ones right now? I know you're probably working on
that. Yeah, we had some conversations with different celebrity brands. But one of the things that's very challenging in the industry, I think a lot of people just think that, hey, they could slap their name on the product and then they'll be able to sell it. And honestly, it doesn't resonate, right? Right. So to me and some others, right, I look at Method Man as like the East Coast version of Snoop Dogg in a sense, right?
Okay.
Like a person that's known in the industry for smoking since the time, right?
Yeah.
Since everybody got introduced to Wu-Tang, they were always talking about chronic, always talking about weed, right? So to you know, me, and I think I was in high school when Ha High came out, right? I was even a consumer.
What was it, Pineapple Express, you just said?
Yeah. Pineapple Express.
Yeah, that's another movie. Like, I was even a consumer, and those movies had me like, oh man, I wish, or I'm looking forward to going to college and having these opportunities, right? And,
not an education, but having these opportunities.
So being in this space here, I forgot my train of thought. What were you saying again?
You were talking about
actually it was branding partnership.
So if you are not a cannabis consumer, that you talk about this on a daily basis, you know, you promote it on your social media and people know about this, that's you know, the sales is not going to be there, right? There's been a lot of individual, you know, former athletes or whatever it is, who just want to create a brand, but it's not going to resonate with anybody because that's not what you're known for.
Right.
You know what I mean? So people, so culture. it's not authentic. You know what I'm saying? Absolutely. So you know, people don't really resonate with that. So
It shows.
So Tikal is something that it resonate with.
And it's
people,
a strong brand. Yeah, it's like, a strong it's really brand.
Yeah,
out there.
They're really out there. So they really they made different states, different cities. And this is something that, like I said, they support the community. They you know, every time that we reach out, we have a conversation about, you know, supporting any of our events. They always come through. So you know, our goal this year is to expand. So when we did the release in November. So it was only released into our store. So like now we just expanded for 420 that's coming up. So we in about 5 different stores now. We expanded out to Great Barrington. We out in
where the hell is Great Barrington?
Great Barrington, Western Mass.
Really? Great Barrington. I didn't even know we had a Great Barrington.
Yeah, so it's on the line. It's on the line of you know, close to New York. So you know what I mean. So upstate New York could pretty much, you know, be able to drive into Massachusetts and purchase the product. We are at Legal Greens in Brockton.
Oh, shout out to Legal Greens.
Yeah. So we out there in Brockton. Cush Grove in Cambridge. Shout out to Cush Grove. Shout out to Mike Marcus. Shout out to these guys. We expanded the THC, the Heritage Club. I see you have there.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, yeah.
We need a low-key one.
I got you. I bought some gifts. You know, I bought some stuff for y'all.
Love gifts.
Yeah. So we expanded to... in New Dea and Fenway as well.
Oh,
so
I think shout out to New Dea.
Yeah, shout out to New Dea. So I think that's the top 5.
I think that's and, I think that's so dope. That type of brand is now a local brand. Like we have celebrity brands here. Yes. I know that a lot of them have Big Poppy, Erykah Badu.
Yeah. So that's what I mean. Like some of those brands don't typically resonate because, you know, Big Poppy's not really out there every day talking about, hey, I'm smoking weed, hey, this is that, check this out. Where you
it's a gimmick.
Up.
Some of them
Yeah. So you wake up, you know, in the morning and it will be a video of Meph saying like, "Oh, before I start my day, this is what I do." And
so, you know, brand association,
I
like that.
Is really
Who
is really important.
Like the,
I can't
think of the name right now. Wiz Khalifa. Wiz Khalifa has to have a brand.
That Khalifa Kush. I mean, that's sort of like having Snoop Dogg. You know what I mean?
So
like, those one of the things. The only thing with Khalifa Kush is just that you know, the growers, he sort of went with a larger manufacturer.
Mm-hmm.
Working with MSO?
Working with MSO rather than, you know, small crafted
cultivator.
Small batch. I could give you the same consistency. So, you know, sometimes you don't.
So then tell us about like this local or neighborhood brand that
the neighborhood
line.
Line that we launched yesterday. We had a launch for Blue Hill Dreams. That we just recently activated. Throughout my journey, right, it was always finding out, okay, how do I make myself stand out? How do I make Lil' Key stand out? How do we differentiate ourselves from everybody else? Mm-hmm. Throughout my journey, what I learned was just that, you know, cannabis was going to a branding aspect, right? So everybody could say that, hey, I have the best flower, I cultivate the best flower, so on and so forth. But what's really going to make somebody resonate with, right? So like you just said, you're a big fan of Method Man. So if you walk into a store, Method Man is selling something, you're going to say, oh, I'm buying that. So for us, for me, I wanted to create identity for the city of Boston. I wanted to make sure the city of Boston has representation in this space. So one of the things that I wanted to do as a consumer, the first time I ever smoked weed was Sour Diesel. Mm-hmm. Which, you know, grew up listening to the Logs, Jada Kids talking about Sour Diesel. So that was the first time I ever smoked, and being a guy from Dorchester, Loki's in Dorchester, so I said, man, we should definitely have a Dorchester strain called Dorchester Diesel.
Yeah.
So from then on, it was just like, man, how about if I call every neighborhood, give every neighborhood some type of representation.
So what are they?
So we have Mattapan, which is Blue Hill Dreams.
And I was just, Tristan just had this one flashing on the screen. I didn't notice that there was a roller skate and Simcoe.
That's Shavu. So
yeah,
so
why did you guys pick those two landmarks?
But like I said, I wanted to give that, you know, representation of Boston, right?
Yeah.
I wanted to make sure what stands out on Blue Hill. Blue Hill Dreams. So I don't know if you noticed, so Blue Hill Dreams, you have the 28 bus leaving Mattapan. right, you can see the road, and then it's driving through Blue Hill Dreams. So when you're driving through Blue Hill Dreams, one of the things that you're going to see is Simcoe's first.
Yeah.
Then you get to see Shavu. Yeah.
Yeah.
I've never been to Shavu.
The 21st on Sunday. Yeah. Come to Shavu's for adult skate and roll.
I don't know how to skate.
You don't got to know how to skate.
I don't know how to skate.
And they got the thing for you to hold on. You got the cord to hold on.
So I wanted to make sure I give, like I said, representation. My office is on Blue Hill Ave. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to make, like I said, Blue Hill Ave has a lot of meaning to me. I've closed a lot of transactions on Blue Hill Ave. The newest one. Spark
absolutely.
So wanted to give representation Blue Hill Ave, High Park Haze.
Back
in the days, Purple Haze was a real, you know, huge mm-hmm. thing. So there was a brother out there selling, you know, hey, so when you give Hyde Park the representation it deserved. West Roxbury, Raiders Breath. Called it Raiders Breath because it's a little more sentimental to me when it comes to West Roxbury because I went to Westie and then like the high school no longer exists.
That's true too.
So I wanted to make sure that there is that representation there. Yep. And mm-hmm. so we went with the high school, with the mascot, with the football field. So the drawing, the packaging is real dope. So it all done by a Boston based artist
D-Loops. Yep, so he is.
You know what I mean?
He is credited with our logo as well.
Absolutely. Oh, so he did your logo as well? Yeah, D-Loops is my guy. So I've known D-Loops since Mattapan Music. You mm-hmm. know, who doesn't exist anymore. So when I used to go out there and buy my CDs from him. And we went to high school together, and the relationship's been since then. And, you know, whenever I need something, it's like, bro, I need this. Oh, what do you need? I don't know. I'm not that creative. I'll leave it up to you.
Yep.
Figure it out. Get back to me.
This is what I like. This is what I want. Do it.
So he's done pretty much all my logos, everything. Low Key Dispensary logo, he's done that as well. So, and, you know, as I was saying that with the strain, so we got High Park, West Roxbury, Roxbury Runts, Orange Line representing JP, and we have Rozzy coming up, Fenway Green Monster.
I want that one.
Huh? The Green Monster.
That sounds potent.
So we basically just gonna give you the top ten neighborhoods of Boston, East Boston, downtown. So we're gonna give you the top ten to basically, you know, back in the days growing up, the top 10 sneakers, top 10 mm-hmm. Adidas. So really just wanna keep that connection and really keep
the train of thought. Yeah. I like the branding segment that you put in that. I want to, you know, just kind of congratulate you for everything that you're doing. People see you around, they see you networking, they see you in high places and low places, all the things, and you are just outside.
I'm outside. Yeah.
Outside.
I go back in because I got a wife and kids. So
that's true.
I'm there with intention.
But the baby is at least the boy is always with you, so he is learning a lot. So I think it's dope to see his dad really out here. What was that, Tristan?
I wanted to know, Jeff, do you see folks of color yielding power in this moment?
Absolutely. I think this is the best time to be a black person, a black business owner. In the city of Boston.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, a black person overall. I mean, if you know how to leverage, you know how to talk to people, you know how to find resources. There's a lot of resources, you know, in the city of Boston right now to encourage and home ownership, mm-hmm. businesses, you know, whatever it is that you need. I'm not really into a residential space, but some of the agents will say, I got my client of $40,000 towards their home purchase. I'm like, what the hell? those exist, you know what I mean? So we've helped at Thumbprint, I believe, I may not be right with the number, but at least five, if not more, than residential homeowners from converting their Section 8 vouchers into home ownerships. Right.
That's dope, because who would have thunk it?
Yeah, so there's a lot of opportunities. I mean, even a couple of months ago, we had an event with the counselor, Ryan Worrell. Shout out to counselor, doing a lot of great work in the community, where he mentioned, you know, if you're a resident Roxbury in Mission Hill Projects, I believe, there's a scholarship opportunity for you to get a full ride to Northeastern.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
So there's a lot of programs that we just not privy to. And right. So, you know, this is sort of one of the reasons we have Kings Amongst Kings is to have these conversations.
Let people know these resources are real.
They're real. Mm-hmm. They're available. So, I mean, you know, with Kings Amongst Kings, I don't mean to go back on there, but like, you know, last year, I think we helped about five, you know, anywhere between five plus black men become homeowners, investors. You know what I mean?
Are they married?
Some of them are single. You gotta come to, you know, whenever.
When are they meet? When are these meetings, Jeff?
You know, how do people join? Last Thursday. Yeah, last Thursday is every month. If you go on the website kingsamongstkingsboston.com, you'll see our events on a monthly basis that we have going on. We're working on doing another event this Thursday. It should be on the website. Mm-hmm. This coming Thursday is the 25th. Trying to find a location here for us to do a mixer. It's a little tough here. Everybody
got a location for you soon.
Yeah. We love that.
And the Kings Amongst Kings, at what age do you have like a mentorship program for young men or what? Because we have.
Honestly, we've been hijacked by women these days. So as you can see, women invaded our space. Mm-hmm. We had a safe space for men. But we have some women who invaded our space, and you know. But the conversation has been great, so we welcome it. You know what I mean? Because sometimes we don't see or hear those different perspectives.
I mean, better communicate with our ladies or with our queens.
Yeah, that was.
I think that is good. Yes. That is a good thing.
That was my therapist. She was my therapist. So that's somebody that when me and my wife were going through some, you know, communication issues. So we had to go see a therapist, and then she was great with, you know, teaching us how to communicate with each other. So I feel like this is something like, you know, every man needs to
even
have.
Even you just saying that is really. I don't know if inspirational is the word, but I think that if people have that mind frame to figure out what we need to make things work, I think that's what that brings longevity and success. You guys have two beautiful kids. You guys have been married for how long?
Going on five years.
And then when you recognize that there was something off, you fixed it.
100%.
And I think that's great.
Yeah, and that's
something as small as that is great.
That's really what it takes. You know what I mean? It's doing the little work. You know what I mean? It's doing the small things that counts. You know what I mean? Ultimately, and that's what it is. A lot of when I talk to a lot of people, it's just say, hey, oh, why do you feel comfortable talking to a therapist? Or you know, like man,
I want to stay married. I don't even see the person.
We don't frequent the same restaurant, the same grocery stores. We don't have the same friends. Mm-hmm. And, you know, they sign an NDA that they can't talk about my problems with nobody. Yeah. So it doesn't matter.
It's beautiful. I mean?
So, it's all about having a different perspective and having a different understanding and seeing things in different ways. Because sometimes... I know last Thursday we had, last month during that conversation, you know, some of us, the way that we grew up, you know, one of the men that was there, we went to college, I haven't seen him in over 10 years.
Yeah.
And he was just talking about how as men, as we communicate, you know, somebody will say to you, man, all right, bro, I'll talk to you later. Like, whatever, right? Like, we could talk to men like that, but you can't talk to a woman like that.
Yeah, I'll see you later. Yeah. No, you see me now.
Exactly. So that's triggering for some women. You know what I mean? So, and not understanding that, and you think that, like, yo, that's just me. That's just how I am. Mm-hmm. It's just like, yeah, bro, that was you. But, like, you can't do that no more.
Now you're with someone.
So you have to change that. So, and you can say, oh, she gets mad at this. But it's like, yo, you the cause of it. Mm-hmm. So you have to change that. So you
very
don't get that same.
Very mature.
You know what I mean? So.
I had this kind of conversation yesterday, and it was not. The same conversation
but like,
with somebody else. Yeah, and so, I was like, that's interesting.
But that's what it is. So it's just like men are not used to having these conversations to understand things. And, you know, I could tell you, right, when we first had our firstborn, this is a conversation you got to have. You have to be able to have with other men.
Yeah.
I remember I was like, Alex Edwards, I was having a conversation with him. I'm like, man, I'm tired, bro.
Mortgage before marriage.
I remember I said, man, I'm tired. I didn't sleep last night. The baby kept me up all night, blah, blah. And he looked at me, he was like, man, get out of here with that shit. You know, like, if you're the one that's going to be out every single day, I mean, you're going to get up and going to be out and your wife's going to be home with the kids. She could take a nap during the day. Mm-hmm. Well, she should be the one to stay up at night with the kid, right? And mm-hmm. then you go, since you're going to be going out to work, then you could be well rested. And then during the weekend, you could switch off.
Yeah.
And I was like, wow. That makes sense.
Sometimes you need people in your life to hold you accountable and to give you a better perspective.
Yeah. Men need to hear it from other men.
Yeah. Men need to hear it from. So I was just like, all right, cool. I'm gonna have the conversation with my wife about that.
Yeah.
Boom, and we did that. So on weekends, right now, since I slept, and then you know what, you could stay in bed till 10. I'll wake up and play with the kids in the morning, whatever it is. You know, because I was able to do that for the next
because
5 days.
It's a partnership. Yeah, right. You know?
But like I said, you know, I got to have empathy and grace, you know, for men that if you don't have that example, if you don't have that, if you're not exposed
to it. Talk about it, yep.
Like, you're not going to be able to do that, you know, and this is, you know, one of the biggest things with us black men is just that after a while, nobody cares what you've been through.
Yeah, because you can't keep using that over and over again.
Nobody cares if you had two goats and mm-hmm. a cow that raised you from the age of 1 to 17.
Yeah.
It was like, well, after 17, you realize you had two animals raising you, bro, now. Of course, find some human beings and you know what
and
I mean?
Get
so,
right.
And get
yeah.
right.
Yeah.
So, you know, but at the end of the day, I have empathy to understand that, like, everybody has that same upbringing. So, you know what I mean? We have to have those conversations to make these changes.
Absolutely.
And that's what's really important.
What's up next for you? And we'll end here.
What's next for me? Getting a second dispensary open.
Okay. Do you already have a location in mind?
Yeah, we have a second location in mind. Really? Not even in mind. We had already started the process.
Ooh.
A couple of years ago, when I came into this industry and realizing what was at stake, you know, so it was just like sort of like go home, go big or go home.
Yeah.
So we, I started the process that there's a cap on how many licenses you could have. Mm. So. You can only have 3 retail licenses, so I went out and started
got all
processing.
3.
I almost did, I got 2. I got 2 retail. The third one was downtown. Downtown became a little congested. And in reality, you know, downtown Boston, it's not like Times Square, New York. You know what I mean? So it's just like it's limited. You know what I mean? It's it's little pockets of what's popping. So I was just like, you know, the fees. Even though I had a great rate on a condo, shout out to this property owner who was Haitian and saw the. You know, the energy and when was about to give me the greatest deal of my life, but the deal fell through. We got a second location in West Roxbury.
Oh, nice.
We also had a cultivation license approved in Hyde Park, but the market has tanked now. So the cultivation market, geez. That's not something that
are
I
there
really
dispensaries want. In West Roxbury already?
There's one.
That's good.
Yeah, we had less competition than we have in Dorchester. Yeah. You know,
those are nice neighborhoods where people just walk in. And they might want to step in a little bit.
Keep
walking high.
Yes. So that's the goal, to get the second location. And we had already started the third, so at some point get a third location and just really just sort of scale this business and educate and provide opportunities, provide jobs for the community. I'm happy with the staff that I have at the location location dispensary. Mm-hmm. All or most of the employees live within walking distance from the store.
Oh, nice.
So I love to hear that. We had a couple of, you know, little issues with at the store with the bathroom, and most of them were able to just go home and use the bathroom. I was just like,
I'm just go home
wow.
real quick.
You know what I mean? So,
I mean, if you're ever looking for somebody to work in front desk, let me know.
Absolutely.
I'm determined to work at a dispensary for some reason.
It's a lot of work.
Determined.
It's a lot of work.
I don't want to work. I just want to work at the place where they check the IDs and say, all right,
you want to be a greeter.
Yeah, I want to be a greeter.
Go greet your ass at Walmart.
Absolutely, absolutely. So I bought some gifts for y'all.
Oh,
so
that's what we're going to end here, with the gifts.
Yeah. And I want to say, Jeff, I definitely see you guys. I see Low Key's logo everywhere. It's dope to see other businesses, that black-owned businesses supporting other businesses out here. I just want to say keep that up.
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
What you got?
It was actually Boston Housing residents that get the full ride to Northeastern.
Boston Housing. Yeah, how do I get into Boston? Oh, it's too late for me. Huh?
It's too late.
I just want everything.
I mean, there's a lot. There's a lot of programs, and you just have to be tapped in with the city of Boston. Shout out to the mayor for doing a lot of great work and making sure that, you know, we feel represented. I remember back in the day, the only reason I used to go to City Hall is to appeal tickets. But now I have way more reasons to go to City Hall. There's way more people that look like me. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I got at the elevator one time, and I just bumped into Chris Worrell, state rep.
Yeah.
And I had just seen him the night before. It was just
let's talk.
I just appreciate the, you know, like I said, we in a good time in the city of Boston, and somebody doesn't know what to do, please tap in with us, Kings Amongst Kings, and a bunch of different other organizations that's doing some work in the city, and you know, help you with housing, help you with investments, helping you with whatever it is, be a better man, be a better individual. You know what I'm saying? So whatever it is,
we need more of these Boston men to get into this Kings of Kings situation.
Let's pass out some gifts.
Let me pass out some gifts. Santa Claus.
This is for you. This is your gift.
I always wanted one of these bottles. By the way.
Wow, that's nice.
This is tequila clase azul. Reposado.
This is for you. This is for trusting me as your agent,
as your broker. Thank you very much.
Very nice
to help you. You know, close this deal and move on and be right in the heart of Dorchester.
Right
and
in the heart of Dorchester. Location.
We gotta crack that open at the grand opening.
Yes, we will.
And then I know you asked for some stickers. I have some stickers.
Let me see. Show the bottle. Let me see.
I remember seeing these back in the day when everybody had them at the cookouts, and I was like, I want one of those bottles. I'm not going to buy it, but I'm going to get me one.
After you open it, can I have it so I can put my flowers in?
I got a little stick.
Good little ones, too.
Exactly. I know everybody got so many on their laptop these days, so I wanted to make sure that.
Yeah.
Well, hold on for a second. So, are you representing Mattapan or Dorchester?
I'm Dorchester.
So, you're Dorchester, you got to go with the diesel. You got to go with the red.
Okay, I got to go with the red.
What's mine? Mine says Blue Hill Ave.
Yeah,
that's where I live.
Yeah.
Okay, there you go. We got another one, Dorchester and the Blue Hill Ave here as well. We got some t-shirts. That's where you live, so I got a t-shirt for you right here.
Thank you. Everybody in my building's gonna be
low-key dispensary t-shirt.
Oh, that's dope. I love it.
You get a Blue Hill Dreamer.
Woohoo! That's me. Yep, I need Blue Hill Dream.
You know,
oh my gosh, I'm gonna wear this to the cookout for the building. They're gonna be upset.
I want to make sure that people see the packaging.
Oh, that's nice.
Those are for me right there.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna put these in the bag. There's some goodies here. I got some infused honey here for one of our vendors.
A little tea.
You know what I'm saying? For a little tea. So it's, you know, it gets real spicy.
And tell your wife that we need some more of them infused.
Absolutely. So I brought it.
Yeah. That's
nice. I brought it in as well. So you got one of these.
Caller, you're live?
Yeah, I just wanted to say good morning to all y'all and Sasha, your friends. But I just wanted to say I really appreciated this interview, man. To hear that Tony raised a good point that you need to hear from men, so I wanted to make sure that this man heard it from me, that it's dope to hear another black man speak so articulately about his emotional intelligence, mm-hmm. his business savvy, his empathy and care towards others, especially with other black men and brothers. So I just wanted to say thank you, sir, and thank y'all for putting the show together today.
Thank you, my brother.
We appreciate you. Jeff, we certainly appreciate you. Thank you so much for coming through today.
You got a rabbit in that bag?
I got some leftover products, you know what I'm saying?
I love it.
So we got the stream bag.
You always got the best merch, too. We got to shout that out. Yeah, you got a good merch line.
We got some flower in here. I don't know who's a flower. Pre-rolls. Yeah. Some edibles. You know what I'm saying? Got a bunch of different things in here, so please feel free to.
I love it. I love it.
Up between y'all.
Jeff, thank you so much for coming through. Thank you for all that you do here in the city of Boston and continue to do.
Oh, look, I say leaving Mattapan.
Yeah, it did.
Once we move into the new space, obviously you'll be invited to our grand opening, and we'll have to talk to you again in the new space so you can see what we did with it. We do appreciate you just in general. Keep up the good work.
Yes, yes.
We got to go to commercial break, is we got to pay some billage, but when we come back, we'll get into the world entertainment and national news. Spark FM Online, number one for urban and Caribbean music.
Appreciate y'all. Thank you.
Let's start with the big question.
Who are you?
The all new Spark FM.
Spark FM invites you to roll bounce
Sunday, April 21st.
Dust off those bell bottoms, baggy jeans, leg warmers, and let's shake, skate, and sparkle.
Ladies and gentlemen, Spark FM is turning four.
Our fourth anniversary celebration, let's boogie on down the rink, throwback style. This all goes down Sunday, April 21st from 8 to 12 a.m. Roll, bounce, and rep your favorite 80s, 90s, and 2000s era.
Music provided by Spark FM DJs.
Shea Boo's resident DJ, Manny Reese.
Cost of is $15 with skate and $20 without. Get your tickets at sparkfmrollbounce.eventbrite.com.
It's 12 past midnight. Don't close your eyes. Your soul's up for life.
Massachusetts Social Equity Program creates pathways into the cannabis industry for those most harmed by the war on drugs. The Cannabis Control Commission offers free education and tools to navigate the legal marketplace, including focused training and support on entrepreneurship, management, entry-level employment, and ancillary vendor support. To apply, visit masscannabiscontrol.com/equity. That's M-A-S-S cannabiscontrol.com/equity.
JP Morgan Chase is making a global commitment to break down barriers to drive inclusive economic growth all over the world. We believe there is a pressing need to help more people move up the economic ladder. That is why we are investing in communities and people to create an economy that works for all, because no community should be left behind. Right here in Boston, we're focusing that work in Dorchester, Roxbury, and Mattapan, among other neighborhoods, on improving financial health. These efforts aim to address the key drivers of the racial wealth divide head-on. We're here to empower individuals, families, and small businesses by connecting them to the tools that build generational wealth and a long-lasting legacy. Chase is investing in Boston. Chase is investing in you. Visit us at the Mattapan Branch at 1617 Blue Hill Avenue, where the team is waiting to help.
Want to give your baby a head start? Get the best protection against flu and COVID-19. Because their immune system isn't fully developed at birth, babies need additional protection. When you get vaccinated while pregnant, it can keep you and your baby from getting sick. As they get older, this can result in more time in school and daycare for them, and more productive time at work for you. Vaccines are safe and effective for children as they grow. No matter where you are on your pregnancy journey, flu and COVID vaccines can boost your and your baby's natural defenses and protect your family. Stay up to date with your vaccines. Stay healthy. Talk with your trusted healthcare provider today. Brought to you by the Boston Public Health.
Finally Home is a must-read, step-by-step guide that will equip any first-time homebuyer with the knowledge they need to confidently make informed decisions. This book provides answers in simple and clear terms to most, if not all, of the questions you may have about credit, homeownership, and generational wealth. Finally Home equips the reader with the confidence to be engaged with the home buying process without feeling vulnerable or exploited. Tailor-made Real Estate Easy is not just a catchy hashtag. It is real estate agent and radio personality Taylor Andre's goal. A goal to simplify one of the most challenging processes you will go through as an adult. a goal to educate you properly on credit and teach you the strategies to finding the home of your dream. It is not just a good book or an easy read. It is the secret to a seamless home buying experience.
Boston's new home for urban Caribbean music, Spark FM. Playing all your favorites. From reggae.
Big life, live like a traffic king.
Soca.
I don't give up.
Hip hop.
Younger, no one that back calling me splurge. Why me jump right out the curve? Make this fly like a bird. Spin on the first and the third.
R&B.
I search that five for you. I do that three more times again. I test the five for you. I saw that
Afro beats.
When you see them, give me that. Jump up on my body like Kalima. Dance make you feel like.
And much more. Spark FM. Urban Caribbean music for Boston and around the world at sparkfmonline.com.
In the morning with Miss Hot Sauce, Miss Tony, and Rockstone Triz.
And we are back. We are back. We were just talking to Jeff Samillion of Low Key Dispensary, Kings Among Kings, and Thumbprint Realty. And it's time for us. Yeah, it's got a heavy resume.
That's a heavy load.
Miss Tony's going to just kind of go through the whatever headlines we have left for the next 10, 13 minutes.
Yeah.
And that can be national, world, or entertainment.
Well, the big news that's going on around the world right now is the panel of 12 jurors was sworn in yesterday for Trump's historic hush money trial. The ex-president, of course, blasts the witch hunt as he leaves the courtroom because apparently that's the only phrase that he knows. I think they said the jury is 8 men and 4 women. They have been selected. They had a very, very hard time picking people to be on this jury because people kept on saying that they would really have a hard time being impartial. I think they said one person lied about being convicted and they ended up having to get kicked out. It was a very, very tedious process, but they do have all the people there now for that. There's floods in Dubai, really
the
big floods.
The floods in Dubai are insane.
The story just disappeared. I was trying to read the headline.
Oh, sorry, that was me.
So there's some really bad flooding that's happening there in Dubai. I think 75 feet of flooding or something like that. I don't know. It's a whole bunch of flooding that's
Dubai
happening.
Dubai floods after rainfall. Schools and businesses have been closed across the United Arab Emirates after the country experienced about years worth of rain in one day.
Yeah.
The flooding also disrupted travel at Dubai's international airport, which is the world's busiest for the international travel.
Yep.
Videos posted online showed residents sweeping rainwater out of their homes and luxury cars stranded in Dubai's flooded streets after a storm unleashed the heaviest rainfall ever recorded in the country since the start of data collection 75 years ago.
Yeah, 75 years.
That was well before the country was even founded. Dubai's high-end stores weren't spared either. As rainwater gushed through the ceilings of shopping malls at Dubai's main airport, the runway flooded and flagship carriers Emirates suspended all departing flights on Wednesday. That looks crazy.
Yep. It sound like the sound of Revelation.
So Pastor Troy was trying to tell me that it was a raid, that it was scientists that were collecting rain clouds or something like that. It was called a rain.
What do you mean they were collecting?
Like they were waiting for the rain clouds to pass over, and then they were using a device to reel them together, to capture them, and then it all like went haywire, and then this is what happened. I'm not sure. I forget what he say it's called. Rain.
What are you saying? This is a man-made thing?
Like
here?
It's a man-made thing or something like that, because why all of a sudden these things are just kind of, you know?
In the Bible, they had the
cloud.
Tower.
It's called cloud seeding?
Yes, cloud seeding.
Cloud seeding.
Is that what they're saying in there too?
It says, was this disaster caused by the UAE's cloud seeding program? Officials in the country's National Center of Meteorology have been cited as saying the rain was not caused by cloud seeding. But even they said it's not caused by that.
Okay, good.
It's caused because y'all doing too much over there.
Doing too much.
Dubai.
Yeah.
In the Bible, it had the Tower of Babel.
Yes, when it was going too high. Uh-huh. And the Lord had to change their language so they couldn't communicate. Mm. Hello.
Yeah, that's crazy. Mm. Over in the Wild Wild West, families say organs of deceased Alabama inmates have been removed without their consent. I don't know what that is. What's going on there? They're saying that they're taking the people and organs out of their bodies after they die without.
It's terrible. It's terrible to hear.
It's terrible. It says it's like a horror story movie that I can't wake up from, said someone's son who learned about the missing organs after hiring a private pathologist to perform an autopsy on the body. After an inmate died last year at the Limestone Correctional Facility, his sister-in-law got an unusual call from the funeral home preparing for the body. Did you realize he came back without his organs? Liver, heart, all of your major organs, they were gone. Another inmate had also suffered that. It was only after contacting the University of Alabama, which is among the providers that conducts autopsies for the prison system, the State Bureau family received that they were told was his brain and heart in plastic bags. The lungs and some other organs came back in pieces, but were not all returned.
The hell are you saying?
It's a very, 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 very long story, but apparently they're stealing the organs out of inmates.
Yeah, they've been doing that.
And that's crazy. Why are they doing that?
Stealing them out of live inmates?
No, the dead ones.
Yeah. Oh,
the
dead ones. Okay.
They've been doing that. They've been there's been a lot of reports on a lot of these jails, especially in the South, where you know the family buries their loved ones, and then when they get an autopsy done or something, when they get the body, they find out that all kinds of stuff is missing from them.
Oh wow!
So basically, yeah, the jails are selling body parts.
That's nasty quite, work.
That is
disgusting.
Quite disgusting.
Horrible.
A 16-year-old was shot multiple times while answering the doorbell. The young kids inside escaped harm. This was a 16-year-old cousin was babysitting his two little cousins, ages 5 and 7. Someone rang the doorbell. He went and answered it, and they shot him multiple times. The two young kids were not struck by gunfire. But the 16-year-old was struck in the abdomen and in the arm. No arrests have been made. No weapons have been recovered. They don't know what happened. All they know is that somebody came in and shot him multiple times as he opened the door.
Ridiculously nasty, horrible.
Crazy, crazy, crazy. And that happened where? In, doesn't tell me where it happened. Philadelphia. Down in Philadelphia.
Sounds about right.
Be careful down there. Colorado funeral home owners accused of storing 190 decaying bodies. That's really, really nasty.
Let me ask everybody questions that we need order answers from.
Yeah.
What are you going to do with them?
That's just
why are you keeping them?
Why aren't they burying them?
Yes, and
where are
the
families
yeah.
of these 190 bodies that haven't... I don't understand... I don't get it. So that's what's going on over there. Birds are being killed for trendy gender reveal parties. What is this? Birds being killed for trendy gender reveal parties in cruel viral trend. A shocking social media trend for dying birds for gender reveal parties is leaving them more vulnerable to predators and compromising their ability to
fight
off. Again,
tell me what
foxes.
You're talking about. What are they doing?
A horrendous gender reveal party trend is inadvertently killing birds to get likes on social media. The RSPCA has issued a stark warning to parents-to-be after a pigeon covered in pink dye died in Corby, Northamptonshire. I don't know what that is. animal welfare bosses fear it was dyed as part of a social media-fueled fad made popular in the U.S., which involves releasing birds dyed pink or blue at parties to reveal the gender of an unborn child.
Who the hell gets a bird to sit still to dye it pink or blue? And who opts for that type of... The gender reveals are crazy.
The gender reveals are out of hand.
When did we start these gender reveal things?
I don't know.
Things?
Did you see that episode of 911 where they used the cannon to do the gender reveal and it backfired on him and blew his face up?
Is that
it's
new?
It's crazy. No, it's old.
It says here in February, a pigeon named Flamingo was rescued from a park in New York City. It died after it was dyed pink.
Yep.
After a suspected gender reveal ceremony.
The pigeon was severely unwell and malnourished when it was taken to the wildlife hospital and it did not survive. They're dyeing them pink. The toxins are killing them. And then if the toxins aren't killing them, the toxins are making them so weak that predators are hunting them and killing them.
And so how do we do this? So I open a box and the pink or blue pigeon flies out of it? Like that's what we're doing?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Is it that serious?
Why did we start doing gender reveals?
This is what I don't understand. And then
I don't know.
And then why did we start having gender reveal parties? So And do you get gifts at a gender reveal party?
I don't think so. I hope not.
Bird gender reveal.
I be, in life, I just be confused about, like, I'm just confused about the where people are getting these fun-filled ideas of foolishness. We're going to take a pigeon and dye it pink, and then we're going to open a little can of blue or pink powder and really, first of all, have that amongst yourself. Yeah. Either you want to know when you go to your ultrasound,
right,
or you get to know when you have the baby.
Why do I have to do this?
Yeah, like, why do I have to, well, let me stop, because I'm not getting pregnant again, so maybe if I did, I would want to have a gender reveal.
You gotta pray for the people.
Yeah. I'm gonna have a gender reveal.
Everybody's so disturbed.
Everybody's so creative.
Picture of you doing Duolingo in the club. and then this very last story, that's probably the most important one. Israel launches a retaliatory attack on Iran. That's supposed to be occurring over the weekend. Pretty scary stuff that's going on over
the
there.
Video here.
Yes, go ahead, play that.
And this happened over while we were sleeping at night.
Mm-hmm. Late at night.
Oh. Unprecedented drone and missile attack on its territory almost a week ago. Let's get back to NBC News Chief Foreign Correspondent Richard Engel for the latest in Jerusalem. Hi, Richard.
Good to be with you again. So Israel retaliated. This has been a series of retaliations over the last couple of weeks. First, at the beginning of the month, on April 1st, Iran carried out an attack. Israel carried out an attack on the Iranian embassy in Syria. Then last weekend, we saw that attack, unprecedented attack by Iran against Israel. And then this morning, Israel responded, but in a very limited way. And the key thing is, it seems like both sides now are trying to de-escalate, trying to pull back from the brink. And the reason that it seems obvious is here in Israel, just a few hours after this military strike on a military base inside Iran, just outside the city of Isfahan, life is proceeding here as normal. The military has not issued any guidance for people to avoid gatherings, to go to bomb shelters, to listen to for updated advisories. Instead, people are operating as they would any other day. The airport is open, the airspace is open. And in Iran, significantly, Iran had been saying from the president on down that if Israel did anything, that it would respond ferociously and immediately. Iranian state media are downplaying it. They're brushing it off. In fact, they're presenting it
so
as a win.
So are we strike? We're not. Everybody's going to leave well enough alone, right? Like,
so
we're not.
No. We told Israel, well, I don't want to say we told, America told, but America recommended that Israel don't respond. Do not retaliate against the against last week's attacks. But clearly they have chosen to respond.
Do what they want.
Do what they want.
Israel going to do what they want anyway. They've been like, let me tell you, y'all gave us all this power.
But Israel
is
already in a war with Gaza.
Yes.
You got to remember, so this would be a second war, kind of like a third war that they're doing.
Well, they got to chill out.
You know, yeah.
They either pull out of Gaza, or they get it double time.
It's scary.
Yeah, we're praying that Iran doesn't, you know, retaliate and all that, because this can absolutely spiral. Like I said last week, we are allies for Israel, and there's a lot of other allies that's for Iran. And if we start going back and forth, it's not going to be a good thing.
Terrible. Yeah. What else we got?
That's it for the national news. We're rolling into the entertainment news. Glorilla's DUI arrest on body cam video does multiple sobriety tests. Yo, this Glorilla DUI has been so funny.
Why is it a thing?
So what I saw about it, of course, Glorilla was arrested for DUI. There's a video here, I guess. But apparently, like, the day before, she had taken a picture with some guy, and she was like, whose man is this? Because I want him. Mm-hmm. And I don't care who you are, because you can't fight me anyway.
One of them basketball players.
So his wife now has been doing, like, free glow. I forget their last name, but she changed the name to, like, Frigo Lanville or whatever their last name is. And she's like, she's my sister wife. It's been cute, but, I mean,
this is
get
her.
Him glow. What is it? Go glow.
Yeah. This is her her video here. I don't know if we could.
Wait, so why are the pants off? I do that too in the car.
Just go to the front of my car, okay? This is Corporal Catrice. Are you willing just
to see if you can make it home, I would feel better. Would you be willing to submit to field sobriety tests?
Yeah.
You see?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. So.
What that is, walking the line?
So it's going to be a few of them. It'll be a few evaluations. Okay. We do three.
They said the reason why they pulled her over is because she made a U-turn on a one-way street or something like that.
And I want you to stand still.
Okay.
And I want you to look at the tip of my finger with your eyes and your eyes only, okay? Don't move your head.
That's what that.
Do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
But why she don't got security?
And she was just, sometimes you gotta, she's probably going from a sneaky link house. Her pants wasn't even closed. She probably wanted to go home and bathe and things like that. You know.
She don't got a driver or Uber.
That's what I'm saying.
Some, if you by yourself and you want to take a little, you know, a little something, something, you want nobody to know, why don't you just go by yourself? I can
shout
drive.
Out to my guy who designed those pants, Miante.
Oh, Miante. Yeah. I like that.
Oh, who that?
Miante the goat on Instagram.
Oh, wow. That's nice. That is a nice pant. What else do we have here? Caitlin Clark blocks Antonio Brown after inappropriate post. Caitlin Clark, she's got very strong
features.
Strong features.
Yeah.
Strong features. Caitlin Clark has clearly had enough of Antonio Brown's social media antics. She just blocked the ex-NFL player after he posted inappropriate things about her on his ex page.
Antonio Brown is such a problem.
He's
a menace.
He's the same as the other one, the little crazy one. Give me some of that vagina.
Who's that?
You know, wow. Little crazy one from That So Raven. What's his name?
Orlando.
Yes. Yeah.
What's his name? Is his name Orlando Brown?
Orlando Brown. Yeah.
Are they related?
They could be.
Yeah,
because they're both cracked.
Yeah. Coy Leray just had to put him in his place too, or something like that.
Antonio
like,
Brown too.
Yeah.
Oh.
Because he was trying to get with her and her on her live or something. She was like, yeah, no.
Yeah. AB took to the app not once but three times on Wednesday to say crass things about the WNBA's newest star following her Indiana Fever introductory press conference in an apparent attempt to be funny. What did he say? But most rolled their eyes at the post, including Clark, who straight up blocked the former Tampa Bay Buccaneers wide out for the behavior. Braun, though, still attempted to troll her Thursday, calling her cracker of the day while sharing a screenshot of her block. Only person in the world blocked by both Tom Brady and Joe Biden, AB said. Tom Brady blocked him, Joe Biden blocked him, and now Caitlin Clark has blocked him.
He's absolutely horrible person.
Yeah.
And I don't like him.
Even DeVar Hamlin did it recently, too, following a brief spat with the ex-dealer on the site.
He's a troll.
Yep. As for Clark, it was the second time on Wednesday she had to deal with things she likely would not have preferred to, as a reporter was forced to issue a mea culpa following a super awkward encounter with her.
And you know what? I'm tired of hearing about Caitlin Clark, because I don't understand.
Mea culpa, ain't that the movie with Kelly?
With the Tyler Perry movie.
Yeah, that's a real saying, though, for something. Oh. But I'm tired of hearing about Caitlin Clark. I'm not sure why she is so in the news. I know she got signed to the WNBA. She's a pro now. But she didn't even win the championship. So, again, I'm not sure why we talking more so about Caitlin, or the world is talking more so about Caitlin, than they are about the winning team, annoying.
Right, the winning team with that black coach.
The black coach who broke records. All the black girls who broke black records.
Yeah.
And Caitlin Clark is the only thing that's in. Like, I don't even halfway care that Caitlin Clark and Antonio Brown have communicated.
Yeah. Mea culpa means through my fault. It was my fault, or I apologize.
Yeah. So what they had to do with the movie?
Oh, because it was her fault. Because she did stupidness in that movie. The whole movie, she did foolishness. What are you going to meet at this man's house for? Naked.
Because he was so sassy. About?
It was about her being seduced
by her client.
Mm-hmm.
Taylor Swift did a 2 a.m. surprise in a double album, Tortured Poets. She dropped that at 2 a.m. So that also happened while we were sleeping last night. You can stream it now everywhere. Surprise, surprise, surprise. Taylor Swift gave Night Owls a bonus when she dropped the secret second part of the Tortured Poets department. Swift had teased a mysterious 2 a.m. countdown ahead of the conventional midnight release of Tortured Poets. For Swifties, it was worth the wait as the collection extended by an additional 15 songs. Get it, Tay Tay.
Yes.
Go, girl.
Can't wait to go stream it live everywhere.
Oh.
Listening.
What? Y'all want to watch it?
Nope.
No. It's the 2 a.m. surprise. The Tortured Poets Department is a secret double album. I'd written so much tortured poetry in the past 2 years, I wanted to share it all with y'all.
Good for her.
Thank you, awesome. Tay-Tay. And Kanye West reportedly a suspect for battery in L.A. after allegedly punching a man in the face. It's
probably paparazzi.
He get it. He deserved that one.
Doesn't he punch people in the face?
Nah, that man went and touching people's wife.
Well,
why are you touching people's wife for under their skirt?
To be honest, she probably didn't even have a skirt on.
But that's what they said.
She didn't have no damn skirt on, and she didn't have no clothes on. She looks like she's available to be touched.
I saw something that said she wore Band-Aids on her feet. Don't do that. Shoes don't, at Disneyland.
Nope, Sasha, you can't do that.
Oh, that's true. That's true.
Do not say she looked like she deserved to be touched.
Yeah, she don't. She do not deserve to be touched. It needs to be consensual. However, I seriously.
She looks like she's inviting touches by being naked all the time.
And I seriously believe that a woman who wears no clothing, you know, like, is different.
He pushed her.
I don't know.
You can't put yourself in a position to attract such attention and then get upset when you get the attention that you get, is what I really, really think. I have to stay by that. And other women might disagree with me. I can wear what I want or whatever. That's fine.
No.
You just being naked all the time.
The assailant didn't merely collide into her. He put his hands under her dress, directly on her body. He grabbed her waist.
Oh, well,
he spun her around and then blew her kisses.
How'd he get the chance to do all of that? Like that.
I do not believe she had on a dress.
No, she didn't have on a dress.
She didn't have on a dress.
In the early mornings, they were at Chateau Marmont.
Yeah, like how he had enough time to do all of that before he, like, upon approach, why wasn't he stopped? I don't know. I can't deal with Kanye and any of his controversy. So, you know.
Controversy.
Like
controversy. Ridiculous.
Anyhow, I believe Bobby Steele's is up next here on the Bobby Steele Show from 11 to 1, followed by Feel Good Fridays with Pam Pam from 1 to 3. Make sure that you guys keep it locked right here. Spark FM, number one for urban and Caribbean music.
Oh, please have a good weekend, y'all.
Bye.
Bye, y'all.
You are enjoying the miracle of radio.
Radio. New England's number one urban Caribbean music.
Radio.
Spark FM.
Spark FM invites you to roll bounce.
Sunday, April 21st.
Dust off those bell bottoms, baggy jeans, leg warmers, and let's shake, skate, and sparkle.
Ladies and gentlemen, Spark FM is turning four.
Our fourth anniversary celebration, let's boogie on down the rink, throwback style. This all goes down Sunday, April 21st from 8 to 12 a.m. Roll bounce and rep your favorite 80s, 90s, and 2000s era.
Music provided by Spark FM DJs.
Shea Boo's resident DJ, Manny Reese.
Cost of is $15 with skate and $20 without. Get your tickets at sparkfmrollbounce.eventbrite.com.
It's 12 past midnight. Don't close your eyes. Your soul's up for life.
JP Morgan Chase is making a global commitment to break down barriers to drive inclusive economic growth all over the world. We believe there is a pressing need to help more people move up the economic ladder. That is why we are investing in communities and people to create an economy that works for all, because no community should be left behind. Right here in Boston, we're focusing that work in Dorchester, Roxbury, and Mattapan, among other neighborhoods, on improving financial health. These efforts aim to address the key drivers of the racial wealth divide head-on. We're here to empower individuals, families, and small businesses by connecting them to the tools that build generational wealth and a long-lasting legacy. Chase is investing in Boston. Chase is investing in you. Visit us at the Mattapan branch at 1617 Blue Hill Avenue, where the team is waiting to help.
Did you know that you can now get a standard Massachusetts driver's license regardless of your immigration status? To get help with your application, a list of all required documents, and nearby appointment scheduling, visit mass.gov/WFMA. Your license is your way forward, so why not get started today?